This is the Thriving Dentist Show with Gary Takas, where we help you develop your ideal dental practice, one that provides personal, professional, and financial satisfaction. Here's your host, Andy Traub.
Well, welcome, everyone. This podcast is all about helping you develop a practice that provides personal, professional, and financial fulfillment, or as Gary likes to say, a thriving practice. And when it comes to professional fulfillment, I imagine that nothing could be more fulfilling and exciting than helping a patient achieve great health. And today we know that a patient's dental health is directly related to their overall health. That is an undeniable fact. We have known this for some time now, but today the body of scientific evidence is more powerful than ever to that fact. So today we know that if a patient has poor oral health, they could also have issues with heart disease, stroke, diabetes, early term birth, and cancer, among other very serious health issues. The bad bacteria in the mouth is not just in the mouth, but it's also circulating throughout the entire body, leading to many of these general health issues. So today we're very fortunate to have Dr. Dan Sindelar as our special guest on the show. Dr. Sindelar is the co-founder of the American Academy of Oral Systemic Health, and he is a leader in connecting the dental world with the medical world. Perhaps more importantly, Dr. Sindelar is absolutely passionate about helping his patients achieve great health. So, Gary, thanks for joining us today. I want to say hello to you first.
Well, hey, Andy, it's great to be here, and I am so excited that we have Dr. Sindelar on the show today.
I want to say welcome to you as well, Dr. Sindelar. Thank you for joining us.
And thank you both, Gary and Andy. I'm very proud to be here.
Gary, we got ton to get through. I know you're going to say some nice stuff about Dan first.
This show is going to rock.
So go ahead.
Right now, I'm just going to tell our listeners that this show is going to absolutely rock. So buckle up. If you're driving, I hope you're already buckled up. But buckle up, man. You're in for a treat today.
All right. So tell us a little bit about Dr. Sindelar. Make him blush. And then let's get into some questions.
You bet. In fact, I'd like to kind of start the show with a quote. And this is a quote from none other than Mahatma Gandhi. So Mahatma Gandhi once said, "It is health that is the real wealth and not pieces of gold and silver." Dan, what do you think of that quote?
Oh, I love it. And, you know, I believe that completely in my life. I figure our number one asset we own is our health, and nothing else matters.
Without that, we don't have much, do we?
Absolutely.
So, hey, let me, per Andy's request, let me give you a little bit, give our listeners a little bit of background. Many of our listeners will already recognize you, Dr. Sindelar, but let me go ahead and give our listeners a bit of a background. You are a practicing dentist. Dan is a practicing dentist in St. Louis. In fact, I believe you are a lifelong Missourian. Is that the correct term to refer to someone that was born and raised in Missouri?
Yes, I am. I born and raised in St. Louis and a lifelong Cardinal fan.
Ah, wonderful. And you did dental school at the Washington University School of Dentistry right there in St. Louis. And then you went into practice. And I understand that in your family, you are a second generation dentist. You followed your father, Louis, who started practicing after his tour of duty in the Air Force. I understand your father, Louis Sindelar, started the practice in 1957. Do I have the chronology correct?
You've got that exactly right. And it was quite a pleasure to practice with my father.
And then you joined your father about 1981, I understand.
Yes, I did.
Ah, well, I could actually go on and read accolade after accolade after accolade, and I know that you wouldn't like that, Dan, because we have so many important things to talk about, but let me just suffice to say that Dan is a real-world dentist with awesome background and information on our topic today. So, Dan, if you would, provide our listeners with a little bit more of your background and how your professional journey has led you to where you are today in practice.
Sure, Gary. Like you said, I've been practicing for 31 years and practiced with my father. It's a family-orientated practice, and you know the kind of like the place you all want to go to. He taught me how to be with people, and it was a wonderful way to be introduced into our profession. And along the way, I kept noticing that my 80 and 90-year-old patients that were extremely healthy and living a full life all had very, very healthy mouths. And to the point where we used to joke with them, you have the gums of a 16-year-old. And it was great. And it became almost a game. The ones that were out, and always busy and active were very healthy. And the ones that were not had very unhealthy mouths. And a lot of that they weren't following through with care and all of that. And so that became very obvious. So, I guess about 5 years ago, I wrote a book, Refresh Life, Oral Health, and it's is key to overall health. And then a group of like-minded dentists and hygienists came together, and I was involved with the startup of the American Academy for Oral Systemic Health, because the research was mounting, and we have so many tools right now that can help us. And so that was about 2.5 years ago, and I will tell you the most exciting 2.5 years of my professional life, something I never had foreseen when I was in dental school, on how exciting that part of our profession could be.
You know, it's so cool, Dan, is I was just reflecting on your story. Very often a dentist patient base will often mirror the doctor's age plus or minus 10 years, simply because that, the social circles that you travel in and such, it's very common that your patients will typically, they could range in age. In my own practice in Phoenix, our patients range in age from 3 years old to 103, actually. So it's a wide range, but the sweet spot kind of mirror Dr. Paul Nielsen's age, plus or minus 10 years. So it kind of occurred to me that when you came into practice with your dad, you inherited some patients that were of your dad's generation and your dad's age. And so you got to see some things, and I imagine you got to see the difference between, a healthy and active 90-year-old and one that wasn't. I imagine you had some patients, sadly, that were perhaps somehow made it to 90 years old, but they weren't healthy and active. And so what an interesting looking glass, what an interesting perspective to notice that difference. Well, hey, tell us about the American Academy of Oral Systemic Health. I know about it, but I want you to tell our listeners as if they don't know about it. Tell us about it and tell our listeners what the mission is and why they should become a member. I'll tell you right now, if you're listening to this, you ought to become a member of the American Academy of Oral Systemic Health. It is an awesome organization. It's a newer organization. So, Dan, tell us about it. Tell our listeners why they should become a member.
Gladly. Well, we all remember back in the early 80s when the era of aesthetics and cosmetics came into play with dentistry, and the American Academy of Cosmetic Dentistry showed up. And Jack Kammer was pretty much the founder of that academy. Well, about 3 to 4 years ago, his son Chris and I started putting together the American Academy for Oral Systemic Health. And it is a group, it's an organization of healthcare leaders and professionals that are extremely dedicated to the relationship of oral health and its effects on whole body health. And as we transition into an era of health and wellness in our society, we have an unprecedented number of boomers that are transitioning into the years where they need to be paying more attention, plus just society in general. This is a group that is bringing all areas of healthcare together to, number one, increase awareness, and number two, put together scientific sessions where we can present just all of the incredible amounts of science and research and protocols that can help reduce problems in overall health through oral health.
This is so exciting, Dan, because, think about this now. And if you're listening to the show, think about this. Traditionally, the retirement age, has been thought of to be somewhere in the 60 to 65 years of age. Not that one has to retire at that point, but traditionally that has been thought of as a retirement age. Today, Dan, and I know, and our listeners know, that if you think about that, at 65 years old, you may have a retirement that's every bit as long as your working life. It really isn't, absurd to think that someone at 65 could live another 30 to 35 years, which would be as long as their working life. And they want those retirement years to be active and healthy and vibrant. not the retirement of lore where, you know, we used to just sit on the porch on a rocking chair. And so I would suggest that this is an awesome time to be in our profession, and also an awesome time to be involved in the American Academy of Oral and Systemic Health. Dan, you had a conference this past June in Cleveland, Ohio. For trivia purposes, my birthplace, by the way. But Dan, tell us about that conference and maybe how our listeners might be able to, in hindsight now, after the event, capture some of the magic of that event.
Oh, I would love to. Every once in a while, you get in front of a group, and obviously by being the current president, I was in front of this group. You get, and I know you understand this, Gary, you get in front of a group where their passion and their inspiration and their excitement turns into a completely different entity.
And it's magical. I mean, it's absolutely, this sounds kind of corny, but it's magical.
You feel a different presence out in front of that group. And this was that group. The best way I described it, the night after our presentation, we had a board meeting talking about things, the way I would describe it, there's the two most important days of our lives are the day we were born and the day we discover why. And this is our why, and it is such an inspiring group. The synergy, the energy, we held it at the Cleveland Clinic, which is world renowned. The folks from the Cleveland Clinic and the Cleveland Clinic Wellness Program were just inspired by the information presented, also the energy of the group. We're to the point now we're actually offering Cleveland Clinic Wellness Programs through dental offices because of an agreement we've put together. But it is a group. We bring some of the leading experts in healthcare in general. I believe it was Dr. Chip Whitney stated that at the end of the 2.5 days, the average attendee knew more about inflammatory disease than about 95% of all healthcare professionals. And yet we did it in a way where everybody was inspired and willing to take that back to their practice and be able to incorporate that into their practice. We're a group of all healthcare professionals, so we have a large number of physicians and hygienists and dentists and various other areas of healthcare. And we put on a 2.5-day presentation. The leading experts, I cannot tell you enough. We had Dr. Mike Roizen as our keynote speaker. Dr. Caldwell Esselstyn gave a talk. He is the gentleman that helps President Clinton with his nutritional transformation recently. It just was a fantastic event.
Now, tell our listeners about how they can capture the magic of this event after the fact. I understand you have you very wisely recorded much of the happenings in Cleveland in June, and those are available. The proceedings are available as a DVD set. Is that correct?
Absolutely, we have a DVD set. We record everything. It's actually has the potential for 20 hours of continuing ed credit. And all of the presentations are in the set. Like I stated, we had our keynote speaker. We have some of the leading preventive cardiology specialists present. We had Dr. Yiping Han, who does the presentation on risks for newborns and preterm births. She did the groundbreaking research. We had Dr. Wind, who is with Stanford's sleep medicine department. He's an MD. We have just some of the Tom Neighbors with oral DNA. They're just incredible presentations that will change the way you approach the future of dentistry, and we have that as a set. So, and I would like everybody to know we can offer this set, and by purchasing the DVD set, you can get $100 off being a member of AOSH, and the moment you buy it, that will include 2013 as a membership.
And give our listeners the URL address so that they can order that DVD set.
The easiest would be to go to www.aosh.org.
We'll put that in the show notes, but I just want to make sure they heard it in case they're driving. So, Dan, let's get real practical. I'm gonna drill down and put you on the spot here and get real practical. At the practice level, so imagine that we have a doctor that's listening to the Thriving Dentist Show, and perhaps he or she is just discovering the connection between oral and systemic health. So at a very basic level, can you start with what is oral systemic health and why in the world should anybody be paying attention to it right now?
Sure. And that's the best part of this whole subject is we are finding out we are playing such a key role. And I was at a recent Cleveland Heart Lab symposium out at the Brain Health Institute for Cleveland Clinic. And there wasn't a single physician presenter there that, and these are world-renowned presentations, they all stated that oral inflammation is one of the key sources of inflammation to address in all of the inflammatory diseases that address us. So we've got a problem here. The problem is there are some key situations in the mouth, and I like to think of the whole process we take care of as the mouth, that has a huge influence on not only disease risk, disease complication, and actual disease causality. And we as dental professionals play a key role. Periodontal disease now is being considered a medical disease, and this is not my stating that. This was the former director of the Cleveland Clinic's cardiology ICU unit. So there's some real important areas that we are in charge of. And by incorporating what I call four centers of health into a dental practice, you really can play a key role in connecting with becoming more of a disease prevention specialist in a dental office. I know that sounds crazy, but Dr. Bradley Bale states, dentists save lives every day, and we underplay it.
I love it. You know, Dan, you and I both know this, and our listeners are going to start to see this as well. Just this week in my own practice, we had the wonderful experience of seating a big veneer case. I think it's a 10-unit upper anterior veneer case. And when Paul seated that case and the patient looked in the mirror, literally tears rolled down her cheeks. She was just so excited about the transformation of her smile. And we know how exciting that is. And as exciting as that is, Dan, imagine the excitement of perhaps actually saving someone's life. Imagine that. So, Dan, go backwards for us. Tell our listeners a little bit about some of the diseases we know that are connected to oral health or that have some kind of a connection relationship to oral health. I mentioned them in the or Andy mentioned them in the opening, but tell our listeners more about the things that we know that are connected to oral health.
These are the most important in my mind. We have a huge impact on our care on reducing oral inflammation and its effects on cardiovascular disease. And I get to go to presentations in regards to this all the time. I was one of the first dentists in the world to receive a preceptorship in heart attack and stroke prevention for cardiologists. And in every one of their presentations, it shows just how important it is to reduce inflammatory disease and especially oral inflammation. I can teach, and I do teach a course on this. They're one of the key blood panels being done by the medical profession is for LP plaque 2. And this is a test, this is a blood test that tells us the risk a person has for heart attacks and stroke. It's the only one that was okayed by the FDA. And the only factor we have right now that we know of in healthcare that affects that is oral inflammation. And so we're doing case studies around the country with physicians and dentists uniting, and we are addressing oral inflammation with an advanced protocol, and we're getting LP plaque 2 levels back into the safe zone 100%. This is the most exciting thing I've ever seen in my practice. It's the most exciting thing I've ever seen in our profession. These are early on case studies. But this is really becoming the future of what we do to reduce cardiovascular disease risk. Then on top of that, we play a real important role in reducing complications for patients with diabetes. And there's some huge correlations going back and forth, which one came first, the diabetes or the periodontal disease. We're still not sure. But there's a back and forth situation there that really is important for what we do. And with the onset of what we call diabesity and the future of the problems that this country are going to be facing in healthcare, we're finding now, even more importantly, we play an integral role in reducing healthcare costs, and this is going to be where we become a huge, huge factor in expanding physician-dentist relationships and cross-referrals.
You know, Dan, it gives me an opportunity to kind of lead into something that I feel very strongly, and I'll ask you to comment on. And, you know, sadly, since the American Dental Association has been tracking the incident of the adult population that visits a dentist, they've been tracking that since 1960. In 1960, roughly 50% of the adults in the United States were visiting the dentist on a regular basis. And sadly, in 2010, 50 years later, that statistic was still static at 50%. In other words, 50% of the adults in the United States. And we have listeners to the Thriving Dentist Show in 86 countries now. And so I wonder how that relates in places like the UK or South Africa or India, Australia, where we have listeners. But I suspect that it might even be a lot lower, you know, than our incident of 50%. And Dan, what I get excited about is I think the more people understand the connection between oral and general health, I think it's going to bring more people to the dance. And sadly, and I'm going to make this comment in a sad framework, sadly, there are some people that just won't ever care about their teeth. Now, that's not you and I, Dan, and that's not the people that we tend to hang with.
Absolutely.
But would you acknowledge that statement? Is that accurate? There will be some people in the world that just don't care about their teeth.
And you bring up a really good point. It's if they're just going to take care of that last tooth that they're not sure they want to save, and if all of a sudden times get tough, that tooth becomes a little less important to them.
But they're probably not. I'm guessing. I don't know, Dan. I'm guessing they're probably not coming in to whiten that last tooth. What do you think?
Right.
I don't know. I'm just thinking.
And yet, once they get it, and I've seen this in my practice, the parting of the ways between those that don't really value that is part of their overall health versus the ones that get that. They know how important that is, and then that makes them just completely charged to take care of themselves and take care of their mouths.
Well, I defy anybody that's listening to find someone that isn't interested in their cardiovascular health. At least interested in it. You know, I mean, they may not take care of it as well as they should, and they may not have good lifestyle choices and so on, but I defy anybody to find someone that isn't interested in their cardiovascular health. So I really think that if you're thinking of this at the micro level, how does this relate to your practice? I think this is one of the really cool platforms you can build your practice to become unique on and to be recognized as unique, whether it's within your existing patient base or existing community. In fact, Dan, I'm gonna put you on the spot here. You indicated a few minutes ago that you have four health centers or four wellness centers, if you will, in your practice. Can you talk about those and then also talk about how you feel that helps you develop a thriving practice? You're in St. Louis, Missouri. Let's face it, you've been affected by as we have all over the world. Been affected by the downturn in the economy, but your practice, like mine, is not being affected. My practice is thriving despite the fact that we are in a tough economic condition. And one of the reasons our practice is thriving is because we've chosen to embrace this very topic. So tell us about those four centers and tell us how you feel that embracing those as listeners will lead our listeners to a thriving practice.
Absolutely. And, you know, dentistry is a wonderful profession. And it's a tough profession, and we're running small businesses, and so a lot of industries become obsolete with time if they don't change.
I wouldn't want to be in the horse and buggy age. I wouldn't want to be a horse and buggy manufacturer right now.
And by no means are we obsolete. We do wonderful things. The different eras, we still get people out of pain in my practice. We still restore teeth in my practice. We still do wonderful aesthetics and cosmetics, and I love it. That makes my heart sing. But as time went on, I noticed that there was a little bit more that could be done, and there are dental solutions for medical problems. So approximately the time I wrote my book, I started incorporating different areas of health into my practice. And over that time, my practice tripled. And I'm a one dentist show. I'm in an office in St. Louis. I have, if you saw the size of it, you would pass out. It's 1,500 square feet with a basement that I put some of my infrastructure in. But it's a small house in St. Louis, and I did about three times as much usually per year as the average dental office. And I'm the only dentist. And we've got a wonderful team, but what we've incorporated, and the first thing I would suggest for everybody prior to incorporating the for-profit centers or the four centers of health is to become known for overall health through oral health. And when your patients start looking to you for that, and it's not smoke and mirrors, this is all good stuff and very helpful things, they will flock to you, and they will become disciples for your practice, and they will bring people to you, and they will take care of themselves. You assist them in their health. And so we've incorporated an advanced oral inflammation center. All of these are inside my office. None of these have to be built out, or they're not very expensive to incorporate. But that one, your office is no longer just a cleaning station. You're now assisting patients with heart attack, stroke, and diabetes prevention. We have, systems we have for that. The other thing is we address sleep, and I do home sleep studies and oral appliances, and it's amazing how important a role that plays in people's overall health. We also have I call it the malocclusion center, where we assist patients with dental force related issues and also with alignment of teeth. And I believe there are 45 million Americans that suffer from chronic headaches and migraines, and a lot of that's due to dental force related issues. So we take care of that. And then the most unique one we do is I have what I call a wellness center, and we do advanced cancer screening. We actually scan for antioxidant levels for patients. We coordinate with the Cleveland Clinic Wellness Program programs to coordinate with what the patient presents with, and we do that in our office. So those four areas are the areas I see as what will be incorporated in some form. Nobody has to do all of those, but those are areas I'm really passionate about, and my patients now look to us for that. And it's just from a practice management standpoint, it's been wonderful because we're giving them what they want.
You know, Dan, I'll piggyback on an experience that I have as a coach. One of my clients has his best source of new patients in terms of number and quality come from a local orthopedic surgeon in his town. And let me tell you how this developed. So my client is very involved in oral systemic health. He's a member of your wonderful association and attended the meeting in Cleveland, by the way, and is embracing all of the things that he's learning, and treated this orthopedic surgeon who was in his early 60s. Had some issues with gum disease, and did some things like salivary diagnostics from our friends over at Oral DNA.
Sure.
And through that, the orthopedic surgeon was very interested in all this science, and he started talking to my client to understand more about this, and went through therapy himself. Great results, great clinical results. He was interested in getting well, was very compliant, and did great results. And anyway, from there, it developed to where this guy, this orthopedic surgeon, does primarily knee and hip replacement surgery. That's his practice, is built around knee and hip replacement surgery. He now sends all of his patients that are scheduled for knee and hip replacement surgery to the dental office, to my client, to be screened periodontally before he'll clear them for clearance for their knee and hip replacement surgery. Dan, how's that referral source?
That is the most exciting story, and that's happening.
Well, and now it's
pay attention.
It's just mushrooming. Mushrooming because now he's connected. Now the orthopedic surgeon has introduced my client to a local cardiovascular surgeon, who is now interested in understanding how that the health of the mouth relates to cardiovascular issues, who now they're talking to the OBGYN about how it's related to preeclampsia and early term birth. And think how wonderful those referrals are as compared to, taking out a full page ad in a magazine advertising your practice. It's just so much more effective. Not that we shouldn't be doing, external marketing as well, because I think a well-rounded approach for marketing makes a lot of sense. But isn't it wonderful to nurture these professional referrals? And really, I really do not think that it is too bold of a statement to say that by embracing this, they will end up saving lives. I really feel like the body of evidence points to that statement very clearly. And I know you feel that from every fiber of your DNA.
Absolutely. The first time I heard that statement, I'm a dentist. What are you telling me? Yeah, come on. But that statement is showing up everywhere. Do not underestimate how important a role we play on the overall health of our patients. And that is being repeated time after time by individuals in the medical profession. And they know it, they're getting it. And when you find participating physicians in your area, it is the most gratifying, the most successful part of your referral flow that you'll ever find.
Dan, I want our listeners to take action. Knowledge is wonderful. Our listeners have heard this from me before, but I'm going to repeat it because it's so important. Knowledge is wonderful, but applied knowledge is just inestimable in terms of the value of once you actually apply the knowledge. So I'm going to give our listeners two homework assignments. I hope you've been excited about what you've heard, on the show from Dan. But I want to give you two homework assignments. One, I want you to visit the website for the American Academy of Oral Systemic Health, American Association of Oral Systemic Health, so that you can start to see the great work that they're doing. If their work is inspiring to you, order that DVD set from Cleveland. That'll give you membership in 2013. And Dan, tell us where the meeting is being held in 2013. I believe it's in September. Is that correct, in 2013?
That is correct. This year we're going to hold it to make it a little easier for everybody to get there. We're going to hold it in Las Vegas. It's going to be September 20th through the 22nd. We're still finishing up the location, but we have great, it'll be a destination location. And the speakers, last year we had to turn speakers away. We assume this year will be the same. And we're already getting a lot of interest and we're going to have a real exciting keynote speaker.
Ah, how cool. So with the purchase of that DVD set, you'll have membership in 2013, and that will provide you an entree to attending that event in Las Vegas. Las Vegas, what a wonderful location, and I'm sure our guests will be able to combine some learning and some fun out there. So the first homework assignment is go visit the website, and secondly, I'd like to invite our listeners to go visit your website, your dental office website, Dan, so they can start to see some of the things that you've done to incorporate those four wellness centers, and I hope they create some visiting your website will create some inspiration for how they might begin to start to embrace those centers. Dan, share your URL for your dental practice website, if you would.
Sure. What it is, just basically my name. It's drdansindelar.com. That's www.drdansindelar.com.
Ah, terrific. Well, Andy, I think you can see why I wanted to have Dan on our show. This topic is profoundly important to all of our listeners, and I hope we've inspired some to want to learn a lot more about this.
Absolutely. It's a tragic thing when people do end up with more serious medical conditions, and to know that those who are listening right now one, have the responsibility, but two, have the opportunity to be a part of preventing some of those things or being a part of more preventative actions. I would rather sit in a dentist chair and have some frank conversation than I would to have my wife speed me off to the ER for whatever reason. And so it's exciting to hear about these connections. It's exciting to see what I'm sure in the past and sometimes is still a competitive environment between people in different fields, but to really understand that you're all in the same field, which is health, health for humans. And so I want to thank everyone for joining us today on the Thriving Dentist Show, and I want to invite every listener no matter what country you're in, every listener to reach out to Gary. And you can do that at TakusLearningCenter.com, TakusLearningCenter.com. And here's my invitation to you. Just call and tell him about your practice, and then he'll tell you if or how he can help you finally achieve the thriving practice that you've always wanted. So I'm going to make the invitation to you, whoever you are, wherever you're at, just reach out to Gary and just have a conversation with him and see if and how he could help you achieve that thriving practice that you know that you've always wanted and you know you can achieve. And I believe that Gary can help. So happy holidays to both of you. Merry Christmas. And thanks for your time today.
You know, Dan, you know, I know Dan is also very active on social media. We interact together on Facebook and also on Twitter. Dan, would you share your Twitter handle for our listeners if they'd like to connect with you on Twitter? And also, if you would, what would be the best way for our listeners to reach you if they'd like to reach out to you and perhaps follow up on some of the things they've learned on the show?
Oh, I would love to anybody who has any questions. Obviously, you can tell this is my passion. This is my sole purpose. And I love talking about this subject. And it goes on and on and on. I love it. But follow us at Dr. Dan Sindelar on Twitter. And also feel free to email me. And my email is drdansindelar, so Dr. Dan at drdansindelar.com. And if you go to my website, we also have a phone number. If you have any requests for any information, feel free to contact Ashley. Ashley takes care of everybody and everyone.
We need more Ashleys in our lives, don't we, Dan?
Well, thank you, gentlemen, both for your time today, and folks, thanks for listening. We appreciate your time.
Dry your eyes. Better days are sure to come. And when you smile, be sure to smile wide. And don't let them know that they have won. And when you walk, walk with pride. Don't show the hurt inside, because the pain will soon be gone.